Hi everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Orfia and today's video is going to be a small tutorial on how to create a top out of a pair of fishnet tights. Now, first things first, you will only need two things. The first one are fishnet tights. The fishnet tights that you want to be turning into a top. Now, I have purchased these in my local Action. I think they were €2 a pair. You can also find these on eBay, on Amazon. You can find them practically everywhere. You can even buy these at Primark, etc. Now, I usually go for a bigger whole fishnet, but I couldn't find them when I was looking for them. So today I will be using these ones. Now, the second thing you need are scissors. And if you have them, I would highly recommend using fabric scissors because it will make your life a lot easier, and these are of course for cutting up the fishnets. So the first thing you want to do if you have, like me, brand new fishnets is take them out of the package. So now we have a pair of fishnet tights. Now, what is important for these fishnet tights in order to become a top? It's actually two things. The first one is cutting off the feet. So I'm not sure how well you can see this, but the top part is actually made of tighter knit mesh, or whatever you want to call it. So it's actually this top section that we're gonna cut off. So you will want to cut more or less about here where this tighter stuff ends. So you'd simply take your scissors, take one at a time and snip it off. And if you have fabric scissors, this only takes 1 second to do that. And what I like to do is have them the same length. So I will take the pair that I just cut up, line it up with the other one, and just snip off the other side as well. You can of course also do it together. So now that we have cut off the feet, it is time to look for the hole that you're gonna be putting your head through. Now, I personally like keeping this wide band of elastic attached. There's people who prefer it without. You can cut it off, but I personally like it because it keeps everything tight together, but it doesn't really affect the look or anything. I just prefer having the elastic waistband still attached. There's a bunch of people who detach it because it's super tight and it's actually more comfortable without, but you can do with this whatever you want. I'm gonna leave it on here for now. But the crotch part is actually the part we wanna cut open to make this into a top. Now, because this is mesh and because this is very stretchy, you don't have to cut it open a lot. So I would recommend by starting with the crotch piece and just cutting off one or two of the holes that I have. Maybe you just have to cut open one of them, but don't cut too much. Always cut off a little bit, try it on, and then eventually cut it open more if you need to. This is the crotch piece. This is the middle joint, and I'm just gonna be cutting that one and the ones just around it to create maybe a 5 centimeter hole, if it is even 5 centimeter, because this is very stretchy, and when you stretch it while wearing it, this hole might become too big. Now, you can make this, of course, as long or as small as you want to be able to wear it. Just make sure you cut a hole here first before trying it on, because otherwise you will not be able to get your head through. So I am again taking my scissors, going up to that crotch piece and just cutting one and two. And now we actually have a hole in here in the middle. And as you can see, I'm kind of stretching this out, and this is really big enough already for my head. I'm gonna try it on first so you can see what this now looks like. So this is what that looks like when I just put it on over my dress. You can kind of see the net fabric onto my dress. Normally I would put this on first before putting on the dress so it will be underneath it. But right now you can already see that the neck hole is actually really big enough. It just follows the bands of my dress really. And then there's something that I like to do to the arms, because I think this looks kind of funny to me. The sleeves look like this. So you can leave it like this and wear it and have fun with it. But what I like to do, because I don't like my hands to be like cut off like this, I like to have thumb holes. So what I do is I take the mesh fabric and I will look where my thumb would sit. Then I will take my scissors and I will just cut open one of those slits so I can poke my thumb through, and that's it. Now, you can also do this for other fingers, but most of the time I don't find it necessary to cut open slits. So this is the difference that makes by just cutting two tiny holes into the fishnets to be able to wear it onto your hands. I personally like it a lot more. And of course, you can use any pair of tights for this. They don't have to be fishnet tights. I do this with regular tights as well. You can do this with color tights, with larger hole tights, with smaller hole tights, anything you want. I think this is the least expensive way to make a fishnet top, and it looks good with pretty much anything. I think the total cost of this project is €2 because I had to purchase a pair of fishnet tights. I already had scissors at home. You can of course also do this with plain scissors. You don't have to use fabric scissors. I just have them and use those. So yeah, this is a very quick and easy way to make a fishnet top to go with your dresses or with your tops. I have done this ever since I started wearing alternative clothes because it was way cheaper than buying an actual fishnet shirt, because those are very hard to find. And the good ones, or the ones that I find pretty, are mostly around €20, which I find a bit much for just a fishnet top that will probably rip pretty fast because I always get cut on things. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and that it was helpful for you. If you still have any questions or if you have suggestions for other tutorials I should make, let me know in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I make new videos every week and I would love to have you for every single one of them. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon. Bye!